Hi guys.
So today we're looking at a PowerPoint about dinosaurs. And you might ask, why are we looking at dinosaurs when they died off a long time ago? How is this even history? Well, in some ways it might not be considered history, but you have to look at the dinosaurs and see how they lived and what kind of earth or like what kind of world they lived in, because we're still living in the same world. So in order to know more about our world, we can look at how dinosaurs lived. So you can see that as a history on its own.
The beginning. Dinosaurs inhabited the world we live in approximately 230 million years ago. They were the dominant terrestrial archetype, meaning that they ruled the Earth for 135 million years. So, why are they important? And should we even consider them history? Of course we should. Dinosaurs and their unlucky bones can teach us many things about ourselves and the world around us. So they are important. And they are history. The first signs of dinosaurs appeared in the Triassic period, although most of their existence was during the Jurassic period. By the beginning of the Jurassic, the supercontinent Pangaea had rifted into two land masses called Laurasia and Gondwana. This created more coastlines and caused a change in global climate, making it more inhabitable for dinosaurs. Dinosaurs continued to dominate the land and reached their peak in this period, as they diversified into a wide variety of groups, ranging from the carnivorous theropods to the massive herbivorous sauropods. We all know how to classify dinosaurs. We know them as carnivorous, meaning meat-eating, herbivorous, which is plant-eating, and omnivorous, which means both. But there's also other ways to classify them. Dinosaurs are also called archosaurs, and they are sometimes regarded as a superorder. They are then divided into two orders called Sericea and Ornithischia, depending upon their pelvic structure, meaning the structure of their back. So now, finding dinosaurs, or not? So there are some misconceptions about the fossils of dinosaurs. As we mentioned before, dinosaurs were discovered by the Chinese and were thought of as a Kong Long, or terrible dragon. The Chinese would unearth these fossils and take them as dragon bones. They put them to use as ritual items and also put them in traditional medicines, a practice that still continues today. In Europe, dinosaur fossils were generally believed to be the remains of giants and other creatures killed by the Great Flood. Many European tall tales and myths may have been filled by the remains of dinosaurs. Not until the 17th century were there more scholarly views on these bones. History of discovery. So in the 17th century, more scholarly views and scientific descriptions of dinosaurs appeared in England. It started out with the femur of a megalosaurus, which was found at Cornwall in 1676. The fragment was then sent to Robert Plot, professor of chemistry at the University of Oxford, who published a description in his Natural History of Oxfordshire in 1677. And then later, in 1699, Edward Lude, a friend of Sir Isaac Newton, was responsible for the first published scientific treatment of what would now be recognized as a dinosaur, when he described and named a sauropod tooth, Rutellum implicatum, that had been found in Caswell, New Oxfordshire. So began the history of finding the history of dinosaurs. the emergence of paleontology. Would you want a job where you would have to dig up bones all day long under the hot sun? Well, I wouldn't. But some people in 1970 showed interest and aided the birth of paleontology. This was in part caused by John Ostrom's discovery of Deinonychus, a predator that may have been warm-blooded, in contrast to the common image of dinosaurs as sluggish and cold-blooded. Soon, vertebrate paleontology became a global science. Major new dinosaur discoveries have been made by paleontologists working in previously unexplored regions, including India, South America, Madagascar, Antarctica, and significantly China. The field of paleontology and the interest of finding more about these creatures is still alive today, and hopefully will continue in the future, because we want to know more about dinosaurs. So this is the end, guys. Hopefully you found the history of dinosaurs interesting. If not, even if you've taken something away from this PowerPoint, maybe a new fact that you learned, we feel like we've done our job. So thank you, and we love you, Mr. Jezer.